Good morning, it's Friday, March the 19th, and today we're looking at Ephesians 6. Coming to the end of the book now, but not quite there yet. And today we're looking at Ephesians 6, verses 4 to 9. So let's start at verse 4. Fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. Slaves, obey your earthly masters with respect and fear and with sincerity of heart, just as you would obey Christ. Obey them not only to win their favour when their eye is on you, but as slaves of Christ, doing the will of God from your heart. Serve wholeheartedly as if you were serving the Lord, not people, because you know that the Lord will reward each of you, each one, for whatever good they do, whether they are slave or free. And masters, treat your slaves in the same way. Do not threaten them, since you know that he who is both their master and yours is in heaven, and there is no favouritism with him. So there are two parts to what we're reading here, and the first bit leads on from yesterday, in the bit that talks about children obeying their parents, which is a personal favourite of mine. But as we read here, parents aren't let off the hook either, and there is this responsibility for parents to, as Paul puts it, not exasperate your children. And he says in Colossians, fathers or parents, do not embitter your children or they will become discouraged. And when that word embitter means disillusion or make resentful. And it's that tension that parents hold, that we are to inspire, to encourage, but also to discipline and hold in training our children. And it is, as they say, it's this tension that we hold to encourage them and to help them spread their wings, but in that safe boundary of discipline. So they can't go too far. They just understand that there is a boundary line, that there is a discipline, but we also need to inspire them to spread their wings and to have visions, to see what God wants them to do, and to lean into what the path God wants them to follow on as well. And the second bit that Paul is talking about here is how we conduct ourselves when no one else is watching. When no one else is seeing what we're doing and keeping an eye on us. And it talks about this sort of integrity of heart. And it just talks about how we conduct ourselves or serve when no one is watching is equally, if not perhaps more important, because although other people's eyes may not be on us, God's eyes are on us and he sees the motives of our hearts. In Spurgeon, I do love Spurgeon, you may have spotted this by now. But he talks about a verse in 2 Chronicles 31:21, where it talks about King Hezekiah. And it says that he did it, all the things that Hezekiah did, building and working in the temple of the Lord. He did it with all his heart and prospered. And this is what Spurgeon says about it. This is no unusual occurrence. It is the general rule of the moral universe that men who do their work with all their hearts prosper, while those who go to their labour, leaving half their hearts behind, are almost certain to fail. That God does not give harvests to idle men except harvests of thistles. Neither is he pleased to send wealth to those who will not dig in the field to find his hidden treasure. It is universally acknowledged that if a man desires to prosper, he must be diligent in business. It is the same in religion as it is in other things. If you want to prosper in your work for Jesus, let it be heart work, and let it be done with all your heart. Put as much force, energy, heartiness, and sincerity into Christ's work as you do into your business, for his cause deserves far more. The Holy Spirit helps our infirmities, but he does not encourage idleness. And it is this responsibility, another word about responsibility here, to make sure that whatever we do, whether we're frustrated with our work, whether we find it hard going, whether it's not really what we feel we should be doing, we're in that place at that moment for a purpose. And whatever we do, it doesn't matter whether we like our boss or not. Ultimately, God, in a sense, is our boss, for want of a better word there. And whatever we do, we're doing it for him. And we should be doing it wholeheartedly. So yeah, it is that encouragement to do that. So two things from today to make sure, if we're parents, to make sure that we are not winding our kids up, not making them resentful, inspiring them and encouraging them, but also making sure there is that boundary line of discipline for their benefit, as well as our sanity, but also when we are doing our work, whatever work it is, whether it's working for the Lord or working in regular business, that we are doing it wholeheartedly, that we're not leaving half a heart behind and focused on something else and looking for the end of the day thinking, oh, I can't wait for this day to be over to do something else, but being people of integrity, and that being our witness, that we do things out of a whole heart, an integrity-filled heart, but ultimately doing everything for God, for His glory. So I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye.